In this Photoshop tutorial, we're going to learn how to create a realistic rainbow using the new gradients. Even if you don't need to create a rainbow, I urge you to check out this tutorial because there's so many features and things inside of the new gradients that apply to everything that we do. So the first thing we're going to do is grab a gradient, and then what we want to do is do a circular gradient. So we're just going to click and drag. So right now what we're doing is just a foreground to background. So let's change the type of gradient we're working in. So under the gradient, go down and choose legacy gradients. There's an entire hidden library of gradients. Let me show you how to get them. Open up the gradients panel if it's not already open. Choose the hamburger menu and you'll see legacy gradients. And this will add a ton of different gradient libraries to your Photoshop. Now under the legacy gradients, you're gonna see we could use either of these two, but let's grab this particular one, the spectrum one. And this is what we're going to use for our rainbow. Now let's make it a little bit larger. And I'm just going to drag the center. So what we're going to do is we are going to control the spacing of the color as well as custom transparency to get us what we're looking for. So if you look under the properties panel, this is where we can control a lot of the things inside the gradients. So if you roll down, what we're essentially going to be looking at though here is these two stops. We've got the color stop here, and then we've got the opacity controls. So what we want to do is get these colors closer to each other so that the colors are in the outer band. So we can drag with the yellow. Notice as I do that, it gets a little closer, and let's drag all these colors in. The green, the blues. All right, now we want to go even further than this though, but notice it's getting quite difficult because these are really close together. Let me show you a great tip. Pull out the properties panel. Now watch this. As we drag, look at this, we can elongate this slider. And as you can see, we have control over the colors and the opacity in a really, really nice way now. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. I'm just gonna hit the space bar and just drag this down so we can see it underneath. All right, let's look at the opacity control. We can hit any one of these, and if we look underneath, we can see the opacity is zero. That makes it transparent. Now, if we go here, we can see there's an 80% and then there's 100% opacity. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna tear these off. And let's pull the zero on the other side. Now notice as I pull this up, notice this is going from the center. So the right-hand side is the center, the left-hand side is the outer rings of here. So what we're doing is essentially setting the area that we want the transparency to go. So maybe we want to go from here to there. Now of course this little one here will control the blending. See how that can change the way that blends? So I'm just going to ditch this one altogether. And what we're going to do is just go for 100% opacity in the middle for now. And then we're going to have this blend off into the transparent areas. Nice. All right, what we need to do though is we need to concentrate these a little bit more. So let's pull the yellow in a little bit, get it closer. So we want to do a thinner rainbow. Now, depending on how thick you want this rainbow, you'll have these colors either closer or further apart. Look at this. Now, I feel for this to be accurate, this color here, let's double click this blue to bring up the color picker. And let's just go for a little bit more into the purples because I feel like that's a little more realistic what you would see in a rainbow. All right, so it looks like the yellow's a little bit wide. So let's bring that green in a little bit closer. Another thing, notice how this is blending. We can make this look a lot better from changing the method from linear. Let's go to perceptual and see how now we get a much smoother blend, more realistic. And let me just pull that in a little bit, show a little more red there. Now, if you ever look at a rainbow, one of the things you'll notice, the inside of the rainbow is generally a little bit lighter, the sky, because it acts like a lens. The outside of the sky will be darker than the inside. So why don't we do that? So what we're going to do is right here where we have this pink, we're going to add another stop, double click it to open the color, and we're going to choose white. Now notice it's not doing anything yet, but if we take this particular one and change the opacity instead of being zero, look at this. See how that'll fill it in? Obviously, we're not going to go like that. But what we're going to do is take it down to just a small amount. Maybe just 3 or 4%. In fact, I'm just going to drag this stop right off it. Now, this other stop, let's just change this to white. All right, let's just drop these properties down and just dock it again in here. And now we have the ability to increase the scale. See, we can make this thing really, really large. And we can use this point to reposition it. You can make it smaller, have the whole rainbow just kind of going across the sky here if you wanted to. I think what we'll do in this case is let's make it larger. And we're just going to kind of have it going across the one side. All right, once you've applied that rainbow, we probably want to save it so we don't have to create it again. So we're going to go under the Properties panel, under Presets, we're going to click, and we're going to call this one Rainbow. Click OK. Now that's saved, and we can reuse it in other documents. All right, let's look at how we can blend this into the image. So the first thing we want to do is we want to, you know, just go onto the mask here, and we want to have this fade into the area it's going to hit. So we're just going to grab another gradient, and this time we're going to grab the foreground and background, just black to white gradient. Make sure that we change this to a linear gradient. There we go. It looks like it's going the wrong way. No problem. Just flip it around and see how we can just blend this in how we want it to just kind of land. Now we could use blending modes on this gradient if we wanted, something like a screen mode. Or just use whatever blending modes you want. All right, and if we want to get rid of it up here, let's grab a brush. Let's make it a soft brush. Remember, we still have the lighter area in there. So we're just going to paint with that black brush. And of course, the nice thing about this gradient, if it's not quite what you want, you can always grab the gradient tool. You can click on it. We can go back under these presets, and maybe you want a little bit more red there, or you want to bring that transparency in. Let's bring it in a little bit there. Look at that. See how you can just kind of tweak all of this afterwards. And here's another little trick just to kind of smoothen out your rainbow. Why don't we go on the layer, right click, and then we're going to convert it to a smart object. Now we can apply filters to it, and we're going to give it a blur. So let's choose filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And notice as we give it a little bit of blur, we can soften it, make it look more realistic. So let me know in the comments underneath if you learned anything new in this tutorial. And also don't forget to check out part one, where I'm showing you how to do the floating heads like you would see in Hollywood movie posters and stuff using the gradients inside of masks. Check out that tutorial right there. And if you're new to the cafe, welcome, hit the subscribe button, turn on notification, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.